Hello everyone, I'm Maya and we're here again at the Nori Point Environmental Center. Today's the first day of fishing for spring 2020 and we're very excited to get out in the water and see what we can pull up. We're using our very reliable Seining net. This is a big net that we can stretch between two people who are fishing very far apart from each other. And we'll drag it through the shallow waters at the banks of the Hudson with the top of the net floating up here and the bottom of the net sunk down to the very bottom of the river with weights. And as we drag it through, the water will be able to pass through this fine mesh, but no fish will. So we'll do a big loop, pull it to shore, and then show you all what we're catching today. The Hudson River estuary, like estuaries all over the world, are a nursery for young fish. So in the spring, we often catch a few tiny little fish. And as the year goes on into the summer and the fall, our catches get larger and larger. During the spring and summer and fall months, we usually go seining here on the Hudson River with lots of students, where some students will go deep into the river wearing waders like we have on today, stretch the net out between them, and then we have one shallow person that walks along the edge of the river. This type of fishing, seining, using a seine net, has been a way that people have caught fish for generations and generations, you know, long ago, when indigenous people along the banks of the Hudson would fish, they used nets like this. Today we're doing a big sweep through the shallow area of the cove here on the river, getting as deep as we can without overtopping our waders, which are keeping us dry, but also trying to get down to the very bottom of the river, so if any fish in the net are trying to escape from the bottom of the net, they're trapped. Then we'll pull the net to shore, up to the banks, and check it to see if we have any little fish hiding inside. The Hudson River estuary, like estuaries all over the world, is a place of really high biodiversity, meaning that we have lots and lots of different species of fish and birds. Fish in the Hudson have gotten up to the count of 229 different species now. Some of them are new, so they're non-native or they're invasive species, but hundreds of them have been here for a long time. Every time we go fishing, we like to keep track of what we've caught. So we'll write down the species, how many were caught, and then some information about the conditions on the river, the temperature of the water, if there's any salinity in the river, what time low and high tides were, and what the dissolved oxygen is like that day, which are all things that we'll do with you in future videos. All right, so as we pull the end of the net up to the bank, we have to be careful to check every little bit of the pocket to see if there's any fish. Oh, and we do have one little fish today. All right, we'll get into a bucket and show you all a close-up of what you caught. All right, everyone, look what we caught today. One teeny tiny little catfish. It's a pretty exciting first day of fishing out here. Clearly, we can only go up from here. All right, goodbye, little friend. Thanks for visiting. Swim away. Thanks, everybody. We'll see you soon.